Mr. Trash Wheel eats garbage from the harbor. Welcome back to Good News Next Week, everybody. I'm James Evan Pilato from MediaMonarchy.com, and we've got that story, plus clean your record of bogus drug war convictions. But first, this kind of returns to a story we talked about just about 2 years ago. Vacant lots in Detroit are being transformed into bee farms. Two Detroit locals took a sweet initiative to fight inner-city urban blight by taking abandoned lots and converting them into full-fledged urban bee farms. Detroit Hives, as they're calling it, both by Detroit natives. Notice how abandoned lots were ruining neighborhoods. They were dumping grounds for waste, uncared for and unkempt. But where did the idea for the hives come from? It all started when co-founder Timothy Paul got a cold one blustery midwestern winter. He tried every medical treatment possible but couldn't shake his cold. One wise shopkeep took one look at him and was like, why don't you try some raw local honey? It'll have medicinal properties that is missing from most processed honey. And indeed, he was right. Raw honey, bottled directly from the hive, has trace amounts of pollen and wax in it. Research shows that these minute impurities in locally sourced honey help with seasonal allergies. And this works essentially wherever you are. And that's sometimes the difficulties of wherever you are in the store. Don't buy the local stuff, even sometimes if it's the... organic stuff. I mean, that's something we kind of run into here. The conventional local store does have honey, but it's super processed and you don't know where the heck it's coming from. So even though it does have the organic, which is good, who knows where on earth it's coming from, and it probably isn't going to have any of those local medicinal properties. So that is one of the ways you want to go local rather than organic, and I know we've been making that choice in a lot of ways here at home. Think about all the places who don't have the time or the money or the gumption to get that government seal that says organic, but if you know them, if you trust them, if they're local, you can check them out. That's way more than any stupid government seal would ever mean. Back to our story, Paul managed to shake his cough using actual raw local honey. That was the eureka moment. So he and his partner started thinking about how overgrown weeds and abandoned lots weren't only ugly to the eyes, but they might also give you all kinds of allergies and worse. They decided to kill two birds with one stone, which is a terrible analogy for this story, easing urban decline and producing raw honey with Detroit hives. So what did they do? They bought an empty lot on Detroit's east side in 2017 for $340. Good googly moogly. Let's all start buying up some properties. I'll set up the Media Monarchy record store next to Detroit Hives. So we'll go all the way back to October 30th, 2017 for a Good News Next Week flashback, trading coal mines for beehives. Essentially this exact same story playing out in my home state of West Virginia, where former coal miners aren't learning to code. They are learning to, of course, make wonderful honey for all of us. Love your local beehive maker, beekeeper. We've been getting honey for a long time from Media Monarchy listeners, and we love to get that, even if it isn't sometimes that local honey. Some other relateds here in our first set of stories. Atlanta creates first food forest in Georgia, instantly becoming the largest in America. The Atlanta City Council, Hotlanta, if you like, on a unanimous vote, approved the transformation of 7.1 acres of property near the Lakewood Fairgrounds and Browns Mill Golf Course into a public park and garden, finally turning garbage golf courses into something useful. And of course, your dead malls are next. Meanwhile, the other in Georgia students help provide food for families in need. Food essentially from the cafeterias that hasn't been open, hasn't been used, sending it home with hungry kids. It's pretty simple. And speaking of my local conventional grocery store, Kroger donates $500,000 facility to a rival store so that a town in a Memphis suburb won't be without a supermarket. We call those food deserts. And Kroger doing a little bit of good work. Again, it's you gotta kind of pick and choose sometimes. Hey, at least Kroger isn't openly working with the CIA like Amazon and the rest, are they? Hoy. That's how we get rolling here on Good News Next Week. Episode 80, my friends, and we continue with your cover story this week. Mr. Trash Wheel eats garbage from the Baltimore Harbor, by far the most popular tourist destination in Charm City, aka Baltimore. Over the years, the Baltimore Harbor, I've been there many times, since even the aquarium is pretty awesome to go to. As with much of the city itself, the harbor this began to deteriorate. Luckily, a Maryland resident. And again, these are things coming from people who live in these towns, who see a need in their town. They don't go move away. They don't go yell at the United Nations. They don't get funded by multinational sketchy organizations to tell you to cheer some kid. No, they just do it. A Maryland resident invented a device that's been helping to remove millions of pounds of trash and debris from the Baltimore Harbor. It's solar-powered, connected to a conveyor belt, lifts trash and debris out of the water using a debris raking system. Think about Mr. Burns' OmniNet, which transfers the collected items onto a conveyor belt and then, of course, into a large dumpster. The device is powered by the water that flows through it. It's hooked up to a solar generator. It requires no outside sources of energy. The trash wheel was developed by a small team of scientists led by a researcher named John Kellett. The team's been developing the technology since 2008, which means they've essentially gone through all the trial and error and worked out all the kinks, and everything is working correctly. Again, not a copywritten idea that some corporation's going to own. It's essentially pretty much an open source idea that they are already working on rolling out in other disgusting harbors, of course, in places like California and New York. Our third and final story on this Good News Next Week, episode 80 for the triumphant return of Media Monarchy. Oh, didn't you know? We went to Japan for the 10th anniversary of New World next week. Some of that footage and video and awesomeness is already out there, and a big, huge thanks and love to my buddy James Corbett as we celebrate 10 plus years of New World next week. This series, of course, Good News Next Week, some of the ways that we are winning and solutions-oriented stories, and of course, a spin-off from New World next week. So speaking of cleaning up trash, Clear My Record gets drug war convictions off of your background checks. Now, a lot of this does seem to be a little bit focused in California. But again, it won't stay that way. In the U.S. today, 1 in 3 have a criminal record that appears on a routine background check. Not me, baby. It's been expunged. Nearly every state has passed laws that allow people to clear or change their criminal record. But a small fraction of the tens of millions of eligible Americans actually benefited from these laws because it's overly complicated, costly, takes way too much time. Much like government, there's all these great things, but it's a bureaucracy and ultimately is of little use. So in 2016, a place called Code for America launched Clear My Record as an opt-in service for people seeking record clearance. The core technology reads a criminal record, maps data to determine eligibility for relief under the acceptable statute, and completes the appropriate forms to be filed with the court. They piloted the technology a couple years back in, of course, Calitopia, partnering with district attorneys and starting with the record clearance or reduction remedies available under Proposition 64, aka that marijuana legalization. With Clear My Record, users can hop online, fill out one 10-minute application, and get connected with a public defender or legal aid attorney who can handle their case in every county. So that is pretty darn good news. Now, I noted my own criminal record has been expunged. Yeah, shocker, you guys. I got busted for weed 21 years ago back in Frederick, Maryland. Cops are all super excited. Where are the raves? You know where they are. They're like, we're punk rock kids coming back from Sonic Youth. We don't know about raves or ecstasy or any of that. And we all have a tiny amount of weed that we couldn't have given away to someone. I went to court. I was convicted. It was a misdemeanor. I got a year of unsupervised probation and $50 court costs. And then what happened? Of course, I knew it's on my record. And they said after 8 years, it should be expunged from your record. So when I was basically getting the job at Ground Zero with Clyde Lewis, and thanks to my buddy Clyde Lewis, it wasn't really a job interview. He said, I want James. So I went in and I was filling out the paperwork instead of doing a job application. I just essentially openly asked. I was like, hey, I've got a misdemeanor drug thing from way, way back. I'm just curious if that comes up in the background check. And indeed, it did not come up in the background check. So if you're lucky enough to be in a situation where you know you got the job and you can go, hey, let me know if anything comes up on the background check. You can find out that way. Sad part is I never got my mugshot out of Frederick, Maryland. I made sure to smile and look good for it because I knew it was ridiculous. So that is a little bit of good news, and that comes from our buddy Morgan Lesko. Again, most, if not all, of our stories for Good News Next Week come via tweeters using hashtag Good News Next Week. Some of the ways that we are winning in solutions-oriented stories. We'll end it with the perfect story and related to that last story there. A New Orleans man faced a felony pot charge, and all the potential jurors are like, no way. I don't want to work on this case. There's no way I'll convict this guy. That's what all the potential jurors said. So they basically threw out the case. Imagine that power in all kinds of other cases, all kinds of other victimless crimes from all around the world. Again, sometimes freedom is scary looking, my friends. That's episode 80 of Good News next week. And again, check out the Media Monarchy Kingdom for all the latest on our trip to Japan for the 10th anniversary celebration of New World next week. We've got some exclusive video coming up very soon. So you've seen the big long 40-minute interview where James and I sit outside and just talk about 10 years of New World next week. We actually shot something where, after we went to one of the numerous record stores I made us go to in Japan, we each shot a version of What's in My Bag, where James asks me about what was in my bag, what I bought from the record store. And then I turn around and ask him what's in his bag, what he bought at the record store. He's going to publish the video with me talking about my giant stack of stuff. I'm going to publish the interview with Corbett that just shows his two purchases that we talk about. That and so much more is coming from the independent, non-commercial, alternative media outlet known as Media Monarchy. We will return to the air next week. That'll be October 21st for those of you keeping score. Sorry I was off the air so much, but we were in Japan for 2 weeks. I've never been out of the country. Takes a little bit to get back on my schedule. Of course, had to deal with, you know, the money stuff and just general life when we got back. So I appreciate your support being off that much time. And again, there's people who signed up while we were away. A huge thanks to all the people who became brand new Media Monarchy members while we were celebrating the 10th anniversary of New World next week. A big, huge thanks to them. Excited to see y'all in the chat stream next week as we do stream news, music, memes, and more Monday through Friday, 9 to 5 Mountain Time at MediaMonarchy.com. Hope to see you there. We'll shut down episode 80 of Good News next week. James Evan Pilato for MediaMonarchy.com. As I always like to note, like Jella Biafra says, don't hate the media, become the media. Take care.
You're listening to Media Monarchy with James Evan Pilato. Since 2005, Media Monarchy has covered the real news about politics, health, technology, and the occult, all remixed with music and media that matters. Go to MediaMonarchy.com/support and become a monthly subscriber so you can help keep independent, non-commercial, alternative media going and growing. Thanks.